Okay, I would like to introduce our next speaker. And the name of our next speaker is Rebekka Pilppula. And Rebekka is the Director of Libraries in Turku since 2018. Earlier, she worked as a Director of Joensuu Regional Library and has been a member of the board of the Finnish Library Association and a member of IFLA's Public Library Section Standing Committee. She was the Deputy Chairperson for the Council of Public Libraries and the Chairperson also from 2013 to 2017. She's also been the Chairperson for the Board of Koha Suomi Limited since the foundation of the company in 2016. So since the talk yesterday from Ari and Nisa-Pekka, I anticipate that everyone is really looking forward to hearing another perspective on how this talk is titled World's Best Libraries. And after yesterday's talk, I think we're all very much looking forward to hearing more about how that is the case in Finland. Thank you very much. We look forward to your talk, Rebekka.
Hello everybody, I'm Rebekka Pilppula from Finland. I'm the director of Turku City Libraries and I'm also chairman of the board of Koha Suomi Limited. Since the founding of the company it was 2016. I've been working as a library director since 2002. First in Joensuu and now I've been in Turku since 2018. So I worked together with Ari Mäkiranta in Joensuu and you heard yesterday Ari's presentation. He told you shortly about the Koha project of Joensuu and also the founding of our company. But I would like to add some points of view from the library director's point of view. So we started together 2011 in Joensuu. We started the project to evaluate could the open source solution be good enough for us and to the other Finnish libraries. Because I have to tell you that there was several colleagues of mine that they just didn't believe that open source solution library system would never be good enough for the needs of Finnish libraries. For example, we knew that it's quite a Finnish phenomenon to allow customers make reservation to the periodicals and to borrow the magazine copies like any other materials. We also need the loan history for the needs of home help services of the library. We were also wondering, are the notifications of due dates possible in Koha, and etc. etc. We had a lot of questions. But most of them were answered. And we were ready to jump into the world of open source solutions 2014 in Joensuu. And we started to go with Koha. And Joensuu Regional Library was the first public library to make the transition to Koha in Finland. But we got some friends and they wanted to make the same step. So there were five other libraries, or more like to say five other consortiums, and they wanted to start cooperation with us, and we wanted to share the management work, and we wanted to get organized somehow. And it was not an easy task, because we all had added a lot of code of our own to implement the features that we were used to having in our own library systems. We made several kind of researches, and then we decided to set up a limited company 4 years ago. It was a little bit scary for me because I'm just an ordinary kind of librarian. I've never done earlier in my working life anything else than these librarian things. So I didn't know anything about shares, limited companies, or how to organize a shareholders meeting annually. But after these 4 years, I know all of these things well enough. I'm not expert, but being good enough, it's totally good for me. But anyway, I promised to tell you about the world's best libraries. And I'm proud to present you the three busiest library buildings in Finland. Yes. The first one, Oodi. Oodi is the new central library of Helsinki, and Helsinki is the capital of Finland. There is around 10,000 square meters of public space, three floors, and Oodi is open 90 hours per week. Nowadays they have approximately 8,000 visitors per day, but when they started, they had over 10,000 visits per day. And I say the public truly has their own building here in this Oodi building. It's in the city center, and directly across the square where Oodi is located is Finland's Parliament House. And if you go to the Oodi's top floor, you are exactly at the same level as the Parliament House. So I think it's symbolically the public is at an equal level with the elected representatives. Time magazine made a list last year about the great places in the world, and they put Oodi on their list. And Oodi was nominated the best library of the year last year at IFLAS annual congress. Anyway, they are still because there was no IFLAS annual congress this year. Then we'll have the second one. It's library Omena. It's Finnish word that means apple. It's a branch library of Espoo City Library, and it's located in the middle of the very busy shopping center complex. Library was opened 2001, and they have very large collections. They have good facilities for information retrieval, and there is lot of cozy surroundings for work, relaxation, and they even have a Japanese kind of garden over there. Their service policy is based totally on self-service, borrowing and lending, lot of automation. And they have also self-service opening hours without staff. So they have opening hours with staff, it's 75 in a week, and 12 extra hours without staff. They have approximately 5,000 visitors per day. And Espoo City Library was nominated for the Library of the Year at London Book Fair last year. And then the best one, my own library. Our main library of Turku City Library, it's the third busiest library building in Finland. We have approximately 4,500 visitors per day. And mine is only one of these three libraries that are going to go to use Koha. We are now running the implementation project. And we started last April, and Koha will be running in production next May. And Turku City Library is not alone in the project. Turku is part of the Waski libraries. And Waski Consortium was founded 2008. And it's a regional collaboration between 18 cities. And we have 56 library units, including 5 mobile libraries. And Waski brings many advantages for the customers, just like one library card, one collection, one reservation queue, common rules of use, material transportation free of charge, and one big e-material collection. So this all means that our patrons can use the same library card in every Waski library. Reservations are free of charge, but uncollected materials are charged with a fee, €2. Reservations in Finnish libraries must be free of charge according to the Library Act 2017. So you can believe that the amount of the reservations has grown since the latest Library Act. And during this year, the amount of the reservations has almost doubled because of the COVID-19 pandemic. In Finland, libraries closed their doors temporarily on 18th March due to the COVID-19 pandemic. And the closure of library premises was initially expected to last until mid-May. But however, the 4th of May, the government allowed all public libraries to restart their lending services immediately. The decision allowed libraries to offer limited services, and that mostly meant that people were allowed to pick up their reservations, whilst the library premises remained largely closed until 1st of June. During this closure and the summer, our patrons changed their way to use the library. Instead of coming to the library and searching the items from the shelves, they started to do more and more reservations. The items customers have reserved may be transported from any Vaski library, also free of charge, and returning the items is possible to any library in the area. All this means that we have daily or weekly transportation from different libraries, and the amount of the transportation boxes that arrive at the main library daily is around 70 boxes, and it means that approximately 7,000 items per day. And about 70% of these items are reservations that need to be handled one by one. And the amount of the transported items is growing all the time. The customer service policy of Vaski libraries is very typical in Finland. Almost 90% of Finnish public libraries are members of the one consortium, like Vaski, and they all have similar kind of services, like this one collection, one library card, the rules and transportation system. I think everyone should have the privilege to say, my library is the best one in the whole world. Actually, quite many people say like that in Finland. According to the customer surveys, about 94% of my library's patrons say that Turku City Library does good or excellent work. Especially, they thank the friendly and professional staff, opening hours and smooth service. And if I ask my colleagues, how did their customer service go? They say exactly the same things. People are extremely satisfied to their libraries. Finland is among the top countries in the world in terms of literature and education. The Finnish Public Library is one of the most advanced and admired in the world, if I may say. Libraries are strongly involved in the implementation of key values of Finnish society, education and equality. Libraries have a traditionally strong role, not only as one of the cornerstones of Finnish democracy and education, but also in people's daily lives. Libraries belong to everyone, as they are funded by tax revenue. Finns, they just love their libraries, and they really use their libraries. Finns are avid readers and library users. So last year, the total annual lending was 86 million items. It means almost 16 items per capita. The annual number of the library visits for was 54 million, and that meant 11 visits per capita. And the internet services of the libraries were used 47 million times. The total material stock is 34 million items. And there must be a library, public library, in every municipality by the Library Act. And most of them have branch libraries. So there is totally 718 libraries in Finland and 135 book mobiles. The continuity and quality of library services are protected by legislation. The first Library Act came into effect in 1928, with the latest version effected in 2017. I hope that I've convinced you about the meaning libraries have in common in Finland. Libraries play a strong role for all in society as an open, free of charge, low threshold service. Our patrons are used to efficient service with excellent quality. I'm just an ordinary library director, so I don't understand much about the library systems or technology. Mostly I'm concerned about the costs, how much the library system will cost. And is the library system efficient enough that my staff will be able to do the customer service as efficient as our patrons are used? You see, there will never be enough money and enough stuff to make everything just like go like a dream. And I think the library system is the most important tool the librarians have. So it is really important how this tool is working. My library is also one of the founding members of Koha Suomi Limited. So you might wonder why the implementation project is running now and not 4 years ago like the other ones did. The reason is there were serious doubts about the efficiency of the Koha. Is it fast enough to handle our loans, reservations, patrons and items? The other reason was that does Koha have all the important functions we are used to have in our own library systems? Will we be able to make the service as excellent as we used to? At the beginning of the 2016, Vaski Libraries made a list of 6 features that must be able to do with Koha before Vaski Libraries will be able to start the implementation project. And then we had the second point and we made the second list, and it was last year. But our first list, Finna. Vaski Libraries have built web services at Finna interface. And Ari told you yesterday about the Finna cooperation in Finland. And nowadays all the Koha libraries in Finland use only Finna as their user interface. Melinda, the national cataloging platform, and Esa-Pekka told you yesterday about the Melinda cooperation in Finland. We also needed interfaces to online stores of publishers. And we were also quite much worried about several implementations of Koha in Finland. And we would wanted to have that there would be only one implementation. And it was because that taking care of those several different kind of implementations took absolutely too much resources. RFID, we had RFID library cards and items. Will Koha support that? So there was our list. And most of these have been done already. So I think Koha Suomi made an excellent work. It's only this Melinda that is still on the progress, but it will be before we will cope with Koha in next May. But during this time, also the development work in libraries continued. For examples, nowadays we don't anymore need these interfaces to online stores. we have another solution. So we made last year a new list, the second list, and we needed also this list to clarify what kind of bigger changes we are forced to do before we go on with Koha. So the second list, the cereals. We would like cereals would be treated like books. We like that the individual cereal volume numbers need to be reservable in such a way that any item with the same number fill the reservation. Slowness. We were very worried about it because there started to be rumors that Koha is slow, especially information retrievals and also handling the pattern information, but maybe even the loaning. So we needed absolutely the answers. Is this true? We have several kind of self-service libraries that and we needed that Koha should support all the self-service library systems that there are available. So instead of the interfaces to online stores, we need an acquisition interface that support framework agreement. We are using now this kind of interface service that goes like this, that it relates to the online store of providers, and the price checking is done by the service. And our purchase will automatically fall on the cheapest price. And that's such a good improvement for the acquisition process that we will never be able to give up this. We were worried about the management system. Is it efficient enough? Is the organization work that's run by Kohacon Limited, is it working good enough? And is it also understandable? We were very keen on about the community level that we are having now in our library system at this moment. So we would have wanted it also to Koha. We were also interested in what kind of future plans there is in the cataloging process. We would like to Koha do the checking the bibliographic records for the errors upon their creation and modification. We wanted also that know that the usability and accessibility of the staff client user interface would be very easy to do. And of course, we were interested in the reliability. Will there be database errors, downtime and downs, or something like that? But almost everything is done from these two lists. And some points at our second list were there only because we didn't know well enough how things work with Koha. But now we know. We have added a lot of our own information. Koha is quickly developing system. And I especially thank Koha Community, the National Library of Finland, and the system developers of Koha Suomi Limited. You all have been doing extremely professional work. Huge improvements have been done. And I feel that my library will safely move to Koha next May. But I have done already a new list. List about things I would like to see in Koha. Like I told you earlier, the amount of the reservation has grown and it will be continue growing. I wish that Koha will have efficient features controlling and handling reservations and hold-ons. Could it perhaps use some sort of machine learning or AI algorithms to control how the reservations get filled and optimize transport logistics related to that? That would be absolutely wonderful. It would be also extremely wonderful if a single magazine copy would be treated like any other item. Information retrieval is already in the progress, and I hope we will have faster retrievals before next May. We are used to do cooperation in Finland. Almost all Finnish libraries are members of the consortiums. We share patron information, we share the cataloging information. We have centralized cataloging work inside the consortiums, and it's shared between Koha Suomi libraries also. We have this kind of one single central Koha Suomi-wide cataloging repository that every library of Koha Suomi uses. At the moment, the records are then transferred from this central repository to the consortium level Koha installations. But my wish is that we will be able to continue the cooperation and in fact deepen it yet further. With some time, we wish to be in a situation where the records no longer need to be stored locally in consortium level Koha installations at all. Instead, we would only have one central bibliography record repository that is shared by all Koha Suomi libraries. It would be a huge change. I think first we need dreams, and then we need just hard work to make them happen. I'm so grateful that you invited me to participate this Kohacon. I'm feeling very honored. Thank you.